The first thing she said was, oh, you from the island, hood? So you know, no. I'm from the island, but right. Like when my floor, my foot can't touch the ground. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But she got me up here. She got me up here, and it's a vibe.
We not up that high, y'all. We only on the first floor.
This is not the first floor, girl. You don't stop.
Hey, y'all. It's Keydra, the entertainment editor here at the Tylt, and I am here with Hood Celebrityy. Got her on the fire escape. It's crazy, but she's here. She's doing it. What's going on, honey? How are you?
Everything is good. I'm chilling.
You look amazing.
Thank you so much.
You look so cute. I love this. Yes.
You know the vibes. The EP coming out.
Oh, we have an EP coming out.
Yeah, my EP dropped on Friday.
Okay. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
What was that second one like, getting all that music together?
You know what it is? Like, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not going to sit here and make it look like it was all easy. But I'm an artist that love being in the studio. And I feel like with music, I'm so picky and hard on myself. So whenever I drop something new, I know if I love it, people's going to love it. Because I put my all into everything I do. I feel like as artists, like, sometimes we put a lot of pressure on ourselves. Yeah. You know, like, just trying to make this one sound like the other one before. And this one sound like the other one. But all I do is just make good music.
Yeah. Because you have critics, but you're still sensitive about your art.
Facts.
Yeah, so I could bet.
You know, see, I don't even got to say nothing, you know.
So what's your favorite song off the EP?
Damn, girl, you got me. I'm going to be honest with you. My favorite song, like, other than Boom Panic, which is what's really big and getting all the attention right now.
That's a new single. Boom Panic, Boom Panic. Say you want me if you come Boom Panic.
Boom Panic, Boom Panic. Say you want me if you come Boom Panic. But my favorite record is Daughter's Cry.
Why is that your favorite?
Daughter's Cry is really about my life.
Growing up, I was so sad. How my mama gave me up to the wrong dad. And I think about it, made me so mad. How sometimes I wish I would have had a dad.
It's really what I went through, you know, like not knowing my dad. Like my mom giving me to the wrong father. So it's like, it's really my life. Like sometimes you hear people write about shit and they sing about shit. But it's really what I went through. Actually, the record made me find my father.
Wow.
So the whole process, yeah.
Wow. And is your father here or is he in Jamaica?
He's in Jamaica.
Okay.
Well, I still got to do 2 DNA tests.
Ooh. Yeah.
So that's what I said, like, the record, like, growing up, I was so sad how my mama gave me up to the wrong dad. Like,
yeah.
It's real shit. So that's what music is about, like, touching people.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if my story could help heal you, that's what music is about. That's what God put me here for.
What gives you the courage to be so vulnerable in your music?
I came to a point in my life where I've been through so much shit and so much ups and downs and stuff like that. Especially me coming from I'm Jamaican, so you know the culture could be sometimes, like, you know, like very judgmental too. Like I just, like, I'm at the point now where I don't care. I feel like my music personally hits me harder when I'm talking about what's really going on.
Yeah, humble beginnings are hard, but of the course. Reality is that it makes you stronger in the long run.
True.
So let me get into a little bit. Came here when you were 12.
Mm-hmm.
Grew up in the Bronx.
Yeah.
What was it like growing up in the Bronx? Because, you know, the Bronx is crazy. Obviously, you're from there. Like, it's notorious for being off the chain. What was it like growing up in the Bronx?
I think when people say, like, the Bronx is crazy, I feel like in the Bronx, as long as you... My grandmother always says, seeing blind, hearing deaf.
What's that mean?
Meaning, like, you see, but you don't see.
Mm-hmm.
So if somebody be like, yo, Hood, did you just see this nigga that just ran down the block? Nah, bro, I didn't see nothing.
Right.
It's basically as long as you can mind your business.
Yeah.
The only thing that was really different for me was just, like, my accent. Like, when I came from Jamaica, I had a very strong accent.
Really? And so many Jamaicans in the Bronx, I would think.
Nah, but remember, I had to go to school, too. But the good thing is that nobody made fun of me. They used to be like, yo, I pay you a dollar. I pay you a dollar for you to say that shit again, that boomba clot.
They like it, yeah.
They like it. I remember I got into an issue with a girl in school back in the days, and she was like, yo, we got beef. See me 5 minutes after school. I called my mom, like, yo, this girl said we have beef.
I thought she meant, like, beef, like, we're going to cook some shit.
Right.
Only beef, that was the beef you eat.
Right.
So my mom is like, no, that means that she want for fight.
Yeah, she got time.
Yeah, so that was the only thing for me, like,
the lingo,
and stuff like that was different until, you know, I got a hold of it. But other than that, it's good. Like, I feel like if you mind your business, you can live anywhere.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. A lot of people say that they feel like New York is, like, dying. It's losing its essence.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what do you think about that statement? Do you think New York is dying or is still popping forever?
I think New York will always be popping.
Our style, like, everything about us is just different.
Yeah.
And it's like,
who don't, like, not trying to be funny, but it's like, who don't want to be from, like, somebody from New York? Like, anywhere I go,
right?
Real talk, like, yeah, anywhere I go, whether it's out the country, mm-hmm, out the states, like, everybody, like, then I'm like, where you from, Jordy? Like, you got a different accent, like,
mm-hmm,
oh, I like those on your feet, or what are those?
Yeah,
like, we just got a different swag. New York would never die.
Yeah,
artist wise, I feel like we can support each other more.
I agree with
I think
that.
That's the only difference. Like, New York, like, everybody want to be the best. Like,
yeah.
And it's cool. Like, everybody want to be the best. I mean, who don't? But it's like, sometimes, like, you don't have to, like, stifle somebody else to be the best.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. Especially when I hear, like, New York radio and things like that. I hear, I don't necessarily always hear New York artists, but I feel like when I go to other cities, they always play, like, their other artists. Like,
facts.
Other clubs.
Like Atlanta.
Like, Atlanta.
Atlanta support they. Artists,
New
like
Orleans
they,
too.
Of course,
New Orleans
definitely.
Too.
I just got back from New Orleans, mm-hmm, definitely. But I feel like we're getting it together because yeah, now you're starting to see more New York artists together.
Yes,
and I'm proud of that.
So talk to me about Walking Truth. So that was like, can I say like your biggest record so
of
far?
Course,
like,
yeah, it's true.
So talk definitely. To me how Walking Trophy came about.
I was just in the crib and sometimes when I miss the gym, I do my little house routine. Like, mm-hmm, I tell people, like, even though you miss the gym, you could still work out at home.
Yeah,
and I was writing. And I just started working out, looking in the mirror, and I'm like, yo, I'm really a walking trophy. Because, you know, like, I really, like, I have a very high self-esteem. Like, I grew up to be like that. Like,
yeah.
I really, like, not in a way where I think I'm better than anybody else, right, but in a way where, like, you can't tell me I'm ugly.
Yeah.
You know, and I feel like every woman should feel like that.
Yeah.
Because if we all like that, then it wouldn't be so easy for people to make you feel, like, down about yourself,
yeah,
make you feel fucked up about yourself. So... And I'm like, but there's other women out there that are walking trophies too.
Right.
And when you make music, sometimes it's not just about you.
Mm-hmm.
Most times it's not about you. You know what I'm saying? It's not about just you.
Right.
Like, you're making music for everybody. How am I going to touch this person? How am I going to make this person feel beautiful? And that's how Walking Trophy came about. I'm like, everybody a walking trophy. Every female, I want every female when they hear this record to get in their bag. Like, to feel like you the shit.
You hear that, ladies? You're a walking trophy. We all walking trophies.
Oh, that's pretty in our real life, yeah?
Period. So talk to me about the remixes. You had Trey Songz on there. You had, yeah, Fab on a remix. Mm-hmm. How'd you get those collabs? Well, they're major.
Nah, thank you. Fab, I met him before. I met him one time. And he was super cool, super genuine. My road manager, Fly Ty, that's like his peoples. Like, they're like brothers.
Mm.
So Fly Ty reached out to him and played him the record. And Fabulous was already, he was already a fan of the record. He fucked with it. So he was like, he's going to hop on the remix.
Love it.
And then for Trey Songz, my label put that together. Like, with him, because like, they cool with him or whatever. And he said he loved the record, too. So he hopped on it, which is dope because I'm a fan of both. So it was, like, to me, the best thing that could happen.
So tell me, who is your walking guy trophy?
For a guy, it would be 50 Cent.
Yeah, 50's the walking trophy.
Yeah, I love 50. I know people think I'm crazy. Like, out of everybody, hood is 50? And I'm like, yes.
Yes.
I love everything about him. I feel like he remind me so much of myself. Just,
yeah,
a male virgin, like, he's very confident, you,
yeah,
know?
He is
real cool dude, laid back. If you mess with him,
yeah,
you know you're gonna have to have his money by Monday. You know what I'm saying? And I love everything about him. All my friends know, like, I've been obsessed with 50 since I was like 16.
I love it.
Yeah,
with your New Yorkers.
Yeah, there you go. See, you're smart.
I love it.
I ain't gotta say much. You're smart.
Talk to me about your dream collaboration. Who would you love to work with?
I would love to work with Drake. I would love to work with Rihanna. I would definitely love to work with Vybz Kartel because,
yeah,
I love his music. Popcorn. I would love to work with Usher.
Yeah.
That was like another idol for me growing up.
Mm-hmm.
I just like, I'm all for good music. You know what,
yeah,
I'm saying? Like, if the energy is good, I'm really big on energy. Like, I got to be able to sit in a room with you and feel a good vibe.
Yeah.
Because I'm big on energy. So if the energy is good and the music is good, like, I'm an artist. That's why I said, like, it's all about unity. Even for like new upcoming artists too. Like, if the record is dope, and I love the energy, and I believe in the record, I work with you.
No, I love that.
Yeah.
So growing up in the Bronx, we know that you grew up with Koury. Y'all were like really close growing up, really,
mm-hmm,
good best friends. Could we see like a collaboration with y'all in the future? Two women from the Bronx tearing it up?
I mean, in life, you never know what happens. So you never know. I don't know. Time will tell.
Time, yeah, will tell.
Time will tell.
What's up for you next? You know, you dropped the EP. You have a new single coming out. You have a,
yeah,
single out. What can we expect from you next?
Y'all could just keep looking out for fire music, and I'm gonna start dropping a lot of freestyles. Like, I just now start jumping a lot of stuff. Like, if I hear a record that's out, that's fire, that I like it, I'm jumping on it.
Love it.
So y'all could really look out for a lot of more freestyles from Hood. And I'm dropping my album. like after the EP, I'm gonna wait for a few and I'm gonna drop the album, which is already done.
Yeah.
That's the crazy thing, yeah.
Okay, so here at the Tilt, you know, we based on like debates and like getting the pulse of the internet. So we asked like a lot of like debate questions just to get a feel of where people are on certain topics. I'm gonna ask you, what do you think the voters picked on the site?
Okay, cool.
Based on the question. So do you think that most people on the site think that cheating is can be forgiven, or you don't forgive cheaters?
I think, well, I don't forgive cheaters.
You don't forgive,
so yeah. I think people would say they don't forgive cheaters, because I don't.
74% of folks on our site do not forgive
but
cheaters.
But if I cheat, though, I do want you to forgive me. But if you cheat, I can't forgive you.
This is always the answer. It's so funny. Okay. So, open relationships. Do you think people on the site are for open relationships or against open relationships?
I'm for open relationships, but I think people are against open relationships.
64% were like monogamy.
Yeah.
They're not with the open love.
I'm not a jealous person. I feel like I used to be when I was younger.
Yeah.
You know what it is? I feel like I changed certain things.
Yeah.
So I would want you to change certain things too.
No, I respect that.
I'm like
that.
one of those people that's like, okay, we can do this now. Okay, I changed my mind.
Right.
Yeah, you're going to do it with me, right? All right, we lit.
Okay, so do you think that after a breakup, you should move on quickly, or do you think that you should give yourself time to heal?
The best thing, right, I would think people would say is for you to heal, but you got to do in life what works for you. So some people don't like to sit down. I would tell you, if you're my friend and you'd be like, yo, I just broke up with this person, da da da. And if you're telling me, like, you don't want to be sad, you don't want to be depressed, you don't want to be in the crib, some people can't be alone. I tell you to move on right away.
Yeah.
But some people would say to heal.
Yeah.
Yeah, but do what works for you.
No, I love that. That's a really good answer. Actually, on the site, 56% of people said heal after breakups. Mm-hmm. But you're right. I feel like sometimes we get so caught up on what you should or shouldn't do. It's like, you have
do
to
what
do
works
what's
for,
good
you.
For you.
Yup.
Yeah, because only you sleep with you at the end of the night and you have to go on to the next day. So I like that answer. Dating apps. Mm-hmm. Do you think they're for hookups or are they for love?
Yeah. I think it's what you make of it.
Yeah.
But some people will say it's for hookups.
It's for hookups, yeah. 80% of folks, are they just for hookups? It's not for love.
I believe.
Yeah.
But sometimes, some situations, you never know what it's going to bring.
Yeah, you never know. Like,
you know what I'm saying? It's like
sometimes
you go in a relationship and you're like, all right, I'm going to use this bitch, I'm going to use this nigga. And it's like sometimes the person you want to use, you end up falling in love with that person.
It's true. Yeah. Those are all my questions. So to this camera right here, you're going to tell them where they can find you, what's next for you, and all that good stuff.
What's up? It's your girl, Hood Celebrity. Y'all can find me on Instagram, Hood Celebrity, HoodCelebrityy. I'm dropping my EP on Friday. You know the vibes. Make sure y'all look out for that. And I got my new single out right now, Boom Pon It. Big body girl, just a wine with the thing fun timing. When you find me, you know, so you find it. I'm with the thing up in shoot pantagi. Walk with the walk, I'm boom pon it, boom pon it.
Yes.
You know the vibes, we're here.
Thank you.
Thank
that
you.
That was dope.
You feel mad comfortable. See, I wasn't even thinking about the height no more.